Hello guys, welcome to my channel. In this video we are going to see about the pudendal canal. Before going into the topic proper, let us take a look on some structures located in the pelvis. So what you are seeing here, this is the hip bone and this is the sacrum, and here you can see the uterus and here you could see the urinary bladder. And here you can see the sacrotuberous ligament. So this sacrotuberous ligament, it is attached to the ischial tuberosity, to that of the sacrum. And then when you remove the sacrotuberous ligament, you can here notice the coccygeus muscle. And then here you could see the iliococcygeus. And here you can see, here you could notice the ischioanal fossa. And this one, this is the anal triangle. What you are seeing here, this one is the anal triangle. And further, if you remove this coccygeus muscle and this iliococcygeus muscle, you can see here the pubococcygeus, and then below that you could see the puborectalis muscle. I'm not going to remove that both. So below that you can see here, this one is the deep perineal pouch. So this one is the deep perineal pouch. If you remove that, you can see the, you can notice the perineal membrane. So this one, this yellow color one, this is called as the perineal membrane. And again, let me show you the anal triangle. So see here, this entire portion, this is called as the anal triangle. This is the anal triangle, and here you can see the ischioanal fossa on both sides. Then of course here you can notice the external anal sphincter, and then here you can see the callus fascia. Below that you could see the superficial perineal pouch, and if you remove that too, you can see here the perineal membrane, this yellow color one. And here what you are seeing here, this muscle, this is the bulbous spongiosus, and here what you are seeing here, this is the ischio cavernosus muscle. Hope by now some structures in the pelvis would have become familiar for you. So let us come back to the point, the pudendal canal. So as I already said, this is the sacrotuberous ligament. It extends from the ischial tuberosity. This portion, this is the ischial tuberosity of the ischium. Ischial tuberosity to the sacrum. This bone, this is the sacrum, and of course this sacrotuberous ligament is triangular in shape and it is more narrower in the middle. And then now I am going to remove the sacrotuberous ligament. So what you are seeing here, this one is the ischioanal fossa. The pudendal canal is located on the lateral wall of the ischioanal fossa. Let me remove this bone. You could see the lateral wall of the ischioanal fossa. The pudendal canal is located on the lateral wall of the ischioanal fossa. This extends from the posterior part of the perineal membrane. So this yellow color one, what you are seeing here, this one, this yellow color one, what you are seeing here, this is the perineal membrane. So this pudendal canal, it extends from the posterior part of the perineal membrane to that of the lesser sciatic notch. So this extends from the posterior part of the perineal membrane to the lesser sciatic notch. Let me bring back the pubic bone so that it will be familiar. So the location of the pudendal canal becomes still more familiar. Hope now you could relate, you could orient. So this pudendal canal, it is located on the lateral wall of the ischioanal fossa, and remember that this pudendal canal, it is also called as Alcock's canal. Alcock's canal. So it is located on the lateral wall of the ischioanal fossa. Remember that this pudendal canal, it extends from the posterior part of the perineal membrane to the lesser sciatic notch. So once again I'm repeating, see this pudendal canal, it is also called as a facial tunnel since it is present in between the obturator fascia and lunate fascia, right? So this facial tunnel, this pudendal canal, it is located on the lateral wall of the ischioanal fossa. Then as I already mentioned, this pudendal canal, it extends from the posterior border of the perineal membrane to the lesser sciatic notch. Now coming to the contents of the pudendal canal. Contents. So the contents of the pudendal canal are the pudendal nerve and internal pudendal artery. So the contents are the pudendal nerve and internal pudendal artery, and not only the artery but also the vein. It also accompanies the artery. So see, this is the pudendal canal and it is just a facial tunnel extending from the posterior border of the perineal membrane to the lesser sciatic notch. Coming to the contents of the pudendal canal, the contents are the pudendal nerve and the internal pudendal artery accompanied by the vein of the same name. So see, this pudendal nerve on the posterior part of the pudendal canal, it gives a branch called the inferior rectal nerve. And the internal pudendal artery also on the posterior part of the pudendal canal, it also gives rise to the inferior rectal artery. Further, the pudendal nerve in the pudendal canal, it gives rise to two terminal branches. One is the dorsal nerve of penis and the other is the perineal nerve. This perineal nerve in turn divides to give rise to the muscular branches which supplies the muscles in and around the perineum, and posterior scrotal nerves or posterior labial nerves. So the internal pudendal artery, this in turn divides into the dorsal artery of penis and also the perineal artery, which further gives rise to posterior scrotal artery and deep artery of penis.